गुड आफ्टरनून माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द चैप्टर रंगाज मैरिज एंड दिस इज द लास्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन। आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू फिनिश दिस चैप्टर टुडे। एक्चुअली लास्ट टाइम वी लेफ्ट द पैराग्राफ्स फ्रॉम देयर व्हेन नरेटर वाज देयर इन द हाउस ऑफ रामा राव एंड देयर रत्ना वाज सिंगिंग अ सॉन्ग एंड रंगा वॉज ऑल्सो देयर बट ही वॉज नॉट एबल टू लिसन द सॉन्ग ऑफ द मेलोडियस सॉन्ग ऑफ रत्ना। सो ही वॉज मिसिंग दैट एंड देयर आफ्टर दैट ही वॉन्टेड टू कलेक्ट ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट यू नो रत्ना। वेरी होपफुली ही आस्ड सी इज नॉट मैरिड। His voice did not betray his excitement, but I knew it was there. She was married a year ago. Now see, here the narrator is telling a lie, means Ranga wanted to just know everything about the singer because she was singing very nicely. And at the first sight of the Ratna, Ranga fell in love with her and wanted to engage himself with her. So that's why he is asking that is she married or not. So the narrator is telling lie here that she was married a year ago. His face shriveled like a roasted brinjal. This shows that it was completely upset. He was completely unhappy when he came to know that the lady was married, the girl was married. After a while, Ranga left saying, I must go, I have work at home. And now he left the place. Now see the expression here in the first line. His face shriveled like a roasted brinjal. This was the complete annoyance and upset. I went to our Shastri the next morning and told him, keep everything ready to read the stars. And now see how he's arranging. Now he will send Ranga to Shastri. The village astrologers. I will come later. I tutored him in all that I wanted him to say. Means he convinced him, suggested him that what are the things he will have to say to Ranga. I found no change in Ranga when I met him that afternoon. What's the matter? You seem to be lost in thought, I said. Mr. Narrator wanted Ranga to see, you know, the astrologers, okay, and ask about the fixing of the problem he was under. I said, nothing's wrong, believe me. Headache. Come, let's go and see a doctor. This was the proposal of the narrator. He said that if you are having headache, then you please go to doctor and get treatment of that. I have no headache. I am my usual self. He is telling that no problem with me. I am just okay, fit and fine, as usual. I went through the same thing when the process of choosing a girl for me was going on. But I don't think that could be a reason for your present condition. Now here the narrator is just coaxing him that I think you are very much upset. The process of just selecting a girl, Ranga stared at me. So Ranga was very much looking, very much upset, okay, very much annoyed. And at the same time, he stared, means with surprise. Come, let's go and see Shastri. And the narrator is leading Ranga to Shastri, the village astrologers. And he will say some prophecy, okay, the future happenings. And that all future happenings were tutored by the narrator himself. I suggested we will find out whether Guru and Shani are favorable for you or not. Now the narrator, means Swami, wanted Ranga to meet Shastri, the village astrologers, and find out the cause of your unhappiness. Ranga accompanied me without any protest. Ranga went, okay, with the narrator. As soon as Shastri saw me, he exclaimed, what a surprise, Shyama. Haven't seen you for a long time. And Shastri was very much surprised and pretend that I haven't seen you for a long time. But we know that Shastri and the narrator met the previous night, okay, or previous day, so that they could fix the problem of Ranga. And what was the problem? They will just say something about future happenings. Shyama is none other than your servant, the narrator of this tale. Here the narrator is telling about his name, Swami or Shyama. He is telling servant. Servant means not here knocker, it is servant means sevak, means helpful person. I got angry and shouted, "What? Only this morning Shastri completed my sentence. You finished all your work and are now free to visit me." He is telling that you please do all your work, okay, and then just come and see me. Had he not done so, I would have ruined our plan by bursting like grains that are kept in the sun to dry. He is telling that if we will leave each other, okay, if I will not leave him, so what will happen? The whole plot, the whole story will be damaged and destroyed. Means the purpose will not be fulfilled. And giving reference just like a grain is there, okay, under in the sun, so that it could be roasted, but it is now bursting. Shastri turned to Ranga. "When did the young son of our accountant clerk come home? What can I do for him? It is very rarely that he visits us." And now see, Shastri is turning his attention towards the accountant son, that is Ranga, and asking that when did he come, okay, and what he, why he is here, okay. He generally visits Shastri. "Take out your, you know, paraphernalia." Aurangappa seems to have, okay, something on his mind. Paraphernalia is a kind of, you know, documents, we can say. Patra, it is Hindi, I know. A kind of book in which they see the future happenings of the person. "Can you tell us what's worrying him?" So, narrator asks to Shastri, "Can you tell him or us that what is the problem, okay, with Ranga that is making him worry, upsetting him, you know, annoying him? Shall we put your science of astrology to the test? And then we would like to see that how well known you are, okay, as astrologers." There was authority in my voice. I spoke to Shastri. Means this statement he said, okay, with a very, in a commanding tone. He took out two sheets of paper, some cowries and a book of palmyra. Cowry is a kind of, you know, coin or metal. Lips saying, now see what he is saying. "Ours is an ancient science, Aya. There is a story to it, but I won't tell you that story now." Now the narrator is trying to divert and deviate the story. But now he is stopping himself. This is not a Hari Katha which allows you to tell a story within a story. You may get bored. I will tell it to you some other time. And the narrator is telling that this story I will tell you later. Because this is not the Hari Katha in which the story within a story is there. Shastri moved his lips fast as he counted on his fingers and then asked, "What's your stars?" Ranga did not know. "Never mind," Shastri indicated with a shake of his head. He did some more calculation before saying in a serious tone, "It is about a girl." And see, after pretending, after just calculating, it was not the calculation. Shastri was actually, the narrator has highlighted the blind imitation of, you know, Shastra and just miracle or this kind of prophecy. This is not true according to him. So he is telling that it is all about a girl. Means whatever problem Ranga is having, it is about a girl. I had been controlling my laughter all this while, but now, means why he was controlling his laughter? Because he knew that what Shastri will say to Ranga, and that's why it was creating a kind of fun. But now I burst out laughing. I turned to Ranga. "Exactly what I had said. The same things I do also think, that it was the matter of a girl and that's why you are unhappy. Who is that girl? It was your humble servant who asked the question. The narrator himself said to the readers, it was the question, okay, of the narrator himself to the Shastri. Shastri thought for a while before replying. She probably has the name of something found in the ocean. Now see how he's pretending and telling the exact answer in a roundabout way. Now see, Kamala, maybe, could it be Pachi, moss? Must be moss. If it is not Kamala, why not Pearl or Ratna? Now it is coming to the name. Okay. So the narrator is telling, means the Shastri is telling that it is all about of a girl and the girl's name must be about something related to sea like pearl or something generally coming Ratna. The precious stone. Ratna means the precious stone. Ratna, the girl in Rama's house is Ratna. Now he is indicating Rama's house means the narrator is telling that Ratna, the girl in Rama's house is Ratna. Tell me, is there any chance of our negotiation bearing fruit? Means can we have that girl? Okay. So this is a kind of one he is creating here. Definitely, he said, after thinking for some time, there was surprise in Ranga's face. And now Ranga was quite unknown with the plot, quite unknown with the strategy of, you know, narrator and Shastri. So he was surprised how he come to know about his, you know, feelings of his mind, of his heart, and some happiness. I noticed it. And the narrator himself noticed some happiness at the face of, you know, the Ranga. But that girl is married, I said. Then I turned to him. His face had fallen. And the narrator said to the Shastri that the girl is married. And then I looked at Ranga. So then the Ranga face fell. Fallen. This shows that become again unhappy. I don't know all that. There may be some other girl who is suitable. I only told you what our Shastra indicated. Miss the narrator making things quite clear that I don't know who is Ratna. It is the Rama Rao's niece or someone else. But I have said only things that my Shastra indicated. Our Shastra indicated. Shastri said, we left the place on the way. We passed by Rama Rao's house. Ratna was standing at the door. I went in alone and came out a minute later. And finally, the narrator was very much, you know, a middleman, okay, a mediator. And then he went into the house of Rama's house and come after a while, after a few minutes. Surprising, this girl is not married. And now disclosing the hidden truth that he told a lie. Now he's telling the truth. It seems someone told me the other day that she was. Other day that she was. What Shastri told us has turned out to be true after all. But Rangappa, means now Ranga was told by the narrator that whatever Shastri was telling that was true. And even today I come to know that Ratna was not married. It was someone who told me that Ratna was married. I can't believe that you have been thinking of her. And now the narrator is turning his attention, okay, to Ranga and telling him that you were thinking about Ratna. Swear on the name of Madhvacharya and tell me, is it true what Shastri said? And now the narrator, being a smart and cunning person, he is telling that take the oath, okay, swear of the name of the god, their god is there or anyone well-known name is there, and tell me what Shastri said is true. I don't know whether anyone else would have been direct. Ranga admitted. The narrator is telling that Ranga admitted, accepted, okay, that yes, Shastri was telling everything true. There is a greater truth in that Shastra than we imagine. And this is the observation, but he does not know that this Shastri and the narrator were completely fake and fictional, and they had plot Ranga to marry Ratna. What he said is absolutely true. Shastri was at the well, okay, when I went there that evening. I said, So, Shastri Gale, you repeated everything I had taught you without giving rise to any suspicion. And now, in the evening time, narrator met with Shastri and thanked him for the repeating the same sentence, okay, and same point of view that he was expecting from his side. What a marvelous Shastra, okay, your age. He did not like it at all. Means narrator did not like the Shastra, but Rangappa liked because he was quite unknown with the plotting. What are you saying? What you said to me was what I could have found out myself from the Shastras. Don't forget, I developed on the hints you had given me. And now is they are making fun of, you know, Shastra, the books, the scriptures, okay. By the help of that, they were just telling the future happenings in the life of other, okay, or in the life of the people. Tell me, is this what a decent man says? Rangappa had come the other day to invite me for dinner. What's the occasion? I asked. It is Shyama's birthday. He is there. He is 3. And now, after next day or some other day, Ranga came to invite the narrator. It is Shyama's birthday. He is 3. It is not a nice name, Shyama. I said, I am like a dark piece of aisle cake. Means because of Shyama was the, you know, the child of the Ranga and Ratana. And this actually story happens 10 years back. And he is telling 10 years after. So he is telling that this happens after some years passed. And they both married. And one day, Ranga came to invite me. And it was the 3rd birthday of their first child. I said, I am like a dark piece of aisle cake. Why did you have to give that golden child of yours such a name? And this was the question, okay, this was the question he asked, the narrator asked, that I am a black man and that's why my name is Shyama. Why you are naming your son, okay, your child, who is of golden color, Shyama? What a childish couple you are, Ratna and you. I know it is the English custom of naming the child after someone you like. And this was the English custom, he's reminding him. Your wife is 8 months pregnant now, okay. Who is there to help your mother to cook? My sister has come with her. Now this is the family work they are doing. Once again, she is pregnant of 8 months. My sister has come with her. I went there for dinner. Shyama rushed to me when I walked in and put his arms round my legs. I kissed him on his cheek and placed a ring on his tiny little finger. And Shyama Shyama was the son of, you know, Ranga and Ratna, and it was a gift from the narrator, a small ring. He just gave it to him. I kissed him on his cheek and placed a ring on his tiny little finger. Allow me to take leave, okay, of you. And now the narrator is telling that, please leave me, okay. I will take your leave and then I will just move for some other work. I am always here ready to serve you. You are not bored, okay, I hope. And finally, after giving explanation of the whole story, he is taking the readers in confidence that I think I have explained this story very nicely and you have enjoyed this story. Is it like this? With this, the story ends. And your homework assignment is, you will do the NCERT questions of this, you know, chapter. So thank you very much. All the best. God bless you all. If there is any problem in this explanation or in this chapter, you may ask, okay, after clicking the paragraphs or the questions in the group or personally on my WhatsApp. Thank you very much. All the best. God bless you all.